Hare Krishna.
Just because a memory can't be deleted doesn't mean it has to be recalled. When we strive to grow in our life, our memories can sometimes hold us back. These memories can be about distressing things that have happened in our life, times when we may have been victimized, or they can be about destructive indulgences and the habits that are addictive which we may have developed thereof. So these memories may keep coming back, haunting us like ghosts. And if we find that in our computer, say some file is corrupting, it's a corrupting file, it is a virus that is damaging our software, we would just delete it. But with respect to our memories, we can't delete them. However, just as there are some viruses in the computer, even if we can't delete them, unless we click on them and we open them, they don't become activated, they stay dormant. It's only when we activate them, then their destructive potential starts. So similarly for us, no matter how terrible may be the memories from the past that we may have, and even if we don't have the possibility to delete them, it is only when we activate them, then they start troubling us. So activation of the past memories happens by our contemplation on them. So if we consider that inside us, we are there and our mind is there. And our mind is the place where these memories are stored. And the mind may keep popping up these memories. Hey, what about this? What about that? So if we learn to become mindful and distance ourselves from our memories, from our mind, thereby from our memories, then we can evaluate the memories. And as soon as they start coming, we can redirect our consciousness elsewhere. So the Bhagavad Gita urges us to be this way proactive, where it says that yato yato nischalati manaschanchalam asthiram tastato niyam yaitad atmanyeva vasham nayet. Wherever and whenever our mind wanders, we can bring it back and focus it on the self by our one-pointed focus, by our vigilance. And the mind may propose this, propose that, but we understand that we are spiritual beings, distant from the mind, and especially when we have a spiritual purpose, then we will not let ourselves get distracted by such things. We'll focus on that spiritual purpose, and we will be able to say no to the mind's promptings whenever they come. So that spiritual comes by the purpose comes by the practice of bhakti yoga. The Bhagavad Gita says that if we become determined in the practice of bhakti, yesham tvantagatam papam jananam punya karmanam te dvandva moha nirmukta bhajante mam dridhavrataha. That by the determined practice of bhakti, we can become free from all inauspiciousness coming from our past. Thank you. Hare Krishna.